Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you how to round to the nearest dollar. So by the end of this video, if I have a dollar amount like I have here in A1 that has cents attached to it, I can round that to the nearest dollar like I have here in cell B1.
Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that.
So if I click in cell B1 and I type equals round with a left parenthesis, the first argument I'm going to be prompted for is number. And the number I wish to round is right here in A1. And then I'm going to type a comma. And the next argument is the number of digits I wish to round. In this case, I'm going to type 0 because I do not want anything to come after the decimal. And then I'm going to close my parentheses and hit enter. And I can see that I'm being returned with $122. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. However, if I go into this cell right here and I change the cents from 20 to 70 and hit enter, I can now see that B1 is being rounded up because 70 cents is over the rounding threshold to the next highest number instead of the next lowest. If you would like to have control over this and either always round down or always round up, there's a function for that as well. So I'm going to click here in B3 and type equals round up with a left parenthesis. And I have the same arguments here. So I'm going to click on A1 for the number I wish to round and type a comma and then a 0 for the number of digits, and then close my parentheses and hit enter. And I can see that I'm always rounding up on A1. So even if I go back here and I put 20 cents back in, I can see it's always going up to the next highest dollar. Now, if I go to B4 and I type round down with the left parenthesis, and again, this is the number I wish to round with a comma to 0 digits, close my parentheses and hit enter. I can see that this is rounding down. And if I change the cents in here back to 70 and hit enter, it's still staying round down. So depending on what kind of rounding you want to use, you have all of these options. And there are even more options for rounding out on our blog. And I'm going to include a link to that blog entry in the description below on YouTube if you would like to go there and learn more. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them for us and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.